For the past 7 years, I've been a ghostwriter. Basically, I write stories that are published under someone else's name, and no one's the wiser. I'm just the ghost who goes to the mailbox once a month to send the next chapter. And once a year, I get my annual piece of mail. Not a letter, not a thank you note, no fan mail, just a fat check. Of course, they weren't so fat in the beginning. After writing 11 novels, I finally decided to write what I know, what I lived. I decided to write my story, and it worked. It's been a wild journey, but a lonely one too. And here I am today, writing the third book of this series, and all the credit goes to Samantha Wheeler, the author that Rolling Stone was raving about last month. It makes me sick. Samantha could notice good writing if Dostoevsky slapped her in the face. She'd be a barista if it wasn't for. One more flight. Anyways, let's not get distracted. It's time to write. I always write in the basement because it's the coldest part of the house. The cold air helps me think, stimulates my creativity, brings back the memories. And today, I have the most important task of this book ahead of me. It's the most important task of any book, really. The opening line. Dreams are really just your heart writing a letter to your mind. Shoot. Have I heard that in a movie before? Maybe. But it's true, right? The opening line. What the? Where are my crutches? Is this where? This is the field by Jack's house. That's where it happened. This is a dream, by the way. It happens to me a lot. Sometimes, things trigger me, and I find myself reliving the past. It's like Inception, but half as interesting and twice as painful. But here we are, so let's talk. You're probably wondering about my leg, right? I wish I could just say I just sprained my ankle last week, but it's been broken for 7 years. Shattered, really. You can't tell, but it's mostly made of metal rods now. 7 years ago, I was at a party at Jack's house. He lived over there, way out in the country. At 1:28 a.m., I decided to leave. I remember the time, because I remember everything about that night. As I walked out to my car in the dark, Jack's dad was driving home, drunk. He didn't see me, and short story short, he ran me over with his Ford F-250, the tire only pinned down my right leg. Do you know what that's like? To have 6,000 pounds of metal roll over your leg, feeling your bones break into a million pieces, not being able to walk normally ever. Time to write that opening line. Let's try something different. How about this? They say character is what you do when no one is looking. Wait a second. Let me make sure I'm not dreaming. Okay. Now we can get some work done. They say, character is what you do when no one is looking. They say, who are they and why do they? No way. Jack's dad? He's alive? You're probably wondering what the heck is going on. He is not supposed to be alive. You see, after the accident, I had 4 separate surgeries on my leg. Oh yeah, and no one knew it was Jack's dad who ran me over. He came to his house that night, took a pit stop to ruin my life, and drove off. Everyone said it was such a shame that the cops never caught who ran me over. Jack's dad never got the credit for what he did. I guess I wish he was more like Samantha Wheeler. No one knew who ran me over, but I knew who it was. And like an eye for an eye, I decided to take a leg for a leg. But I ended up taking so much more.
Look into your heart and let me know. Do things.
How can we see ourselves when we're afraid to look at who we really are? To my parents, whom I've never met, but can't wait to meet soon. To my grandmother, who raised me, taught me how to walk, how to write, how to walk again. To the city of Wichita, to the police department, and to the only one who will probably be most interested in these words. To Jack. I'm sorry. I'd write you a confession, but it's already been written. You just thought it was fiction. My name is Catherine Davis, and I'm the true author of the first 2 books in the Crippled Murder series. You can find proof of this information by contacting Random House Publishers. I'm tired of living in the shadows, of hiding from what I've done. It's time to lift the veil. You see, for the past 7 years, I've been a ghostwriter. But I don't want to be a ghostwriter anymore. Because ghosts don't go to heaven.